about to stop it, and she looks up, and see what the plate is.
Right. Presented by New Amsterdam Vodka. Tonight's game between the New York Islanders and the Philadelphia Flyers from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. I'm John Pritchard-Ross with Kevin Weeks. Let's start with these Flyers, Kevin. 0-6-2 in their last eight. They're going south in the standings. They're seven from the bottom. The Owls are going to catch them eventually because they have seven games in hand. How do you play out the rest of the year as a pro hockey player in a great hockey city when you know things aren't looking good?
You got to be competitive. You have to be a professional. I spoke to their great Eric Lindros.
Yeah, he was a great veteran.
And he's been behind us here. And he just talked about that. The identity of this group, led by Cole Drew, their captain and one of the best players in their franchise history. Who knows? Can he look good up the road in Boston as your second-line center, Bucci?
I think he does.
Trade deadline in March. You've got to think he's be on a lot of teams' radar, a UFA to be. Interesting to see what the Flyers do with him. Meanwhile, the Islanders, they've dug themselves a big hole. Odds on favorite to win the division, short odds to win the East, and win the Stanley Cup. A lot of people had that in the final after last year's run, but they got a lot of ground up to make up, and they have no margin for error.
Exactly. They got to win these games out. That desperation needs to be there for them, and that really starts with their attention to defensive detail. This is a defense-first team. They're not dynamic offensively, so you have to defend with intensity. You have to stay out of the penalty box and play a very simple yet effective game that serves them well.
Yeah, we're projecting the Capitals and Bruins based on their play so far to get around 107 points. Let's face it, Isles fans, you want those teams to maybe get them to the 99-point area, win about 76% of your teams the rest of the way, as you can see right there. That even stiff before the season, but they have a lot of games to make up, a lot of home games coming up after this year. Well, the Boston Bruins are retiring the number 22 today. Willie O'Ree, the first black player to play in the NHL, will have his number lifted to the Raptors in Boston. And throughout the league, Kevin, a video, a really, really well-produced video narrated by you will be played throughout the league. Why is this important tonight?
So important. This really speaks to the growth of the game. Willie, you earned this. You are a visionary, even though you're visually impaired. You are a visionary. We all owe you for eternity. Thanks for all that you've done and all that you do for this great game.
Absolutely. Crimson man. Again, number retired in Boston. But here is the video that Philadelphia fans will be watching on their Jumbotron, narrated by our Kevin Weeks.
That was Tom. You also answered the thing. Either Tom answered your dad, I'm answering them all. Tom, you know, this question my dad said, Tom, yes, you say, you can say,
across the National Hockey League, we honor and pay tribute to a hockey pioneer. Minutes from now, Willie O'Ree, the first black player in NHL history, will have his number 22 retired by the Boston Bruins and raised to the rafters at TD Garden. It was 64 years ago today that O'Ree broke barriers by pulling on the famous sweater for the Spoke B against the Montreal Canadiens. Despite being legally blind in one eye, Willie went on to appear in 45 games with the Boston Bruins between 1958 and 1961, and continued to play hockey professionally for a total of 21 years. In the decades that followed since his historic debut, the NHL has seen a steady growth in players from diverse backgrounds. And since 1998, O'Ree has been an ambassador for Hockey is for Everyone and a force for inclusion and social change, using hockey as a platform to build character, teach life skills, and share the values of the game: perseverance, teamwork, and dedication. Congratulations, Willie, a true trailblazer, on tonight's well-deserved honor. The NHL proudly recognizes you as an icon to generations of athletes around the world. From here on, when a young boy or girl looks up at the TD Garden rafters and sees number 22, they can say with pride, anything is possible.
This time, we ask that you rise and remove your hats as we ask all military and veterans to render a hand salute to our flag and welcome the number one ranked anthemist in the NHL, our very own Lauren Hart, with tonight's performance of the Star-Spangled Banner. Love how Lauren Hart sings that anthem. As always, she nailed it. Welcome to Philadelphia, John Butchergrass, Kevin Weeks. In net for the Flyers, Carter Hart, game 125 of his NHL career. Tough year last year, 877 save percentage, better this year. He's just 23 years old. And Semin Varlamov, his last three starts, he's been money, Kevin. 5-on-5, how about a 9.76 save percentage?
He's been good. He's been incredible. Yeah, Varlamov is healthy and back kicking. And he's been so consistent in this stretch. This is exactly what they need. Goaltending, for the most part, has been outstanding for the Islanders between him and Sorokin. It'll have to be that case here in Philly once again.
We're underway in Philadelphia on Willie O'Ree night around the NHL, and especially in Boston.